टीसी नंबर 324, 5 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट। While moving the motion, the honorable members made a very fine speech giving us a clear picture of what the universities are today and what the universities should be. But sir, I was unable to follow the objects of the bill. The aims of the bill do not seem to be clear even to the framers of the bill. In the statement of objects and reasons, it is said the Constitution of India vests Parliament with exclusive authority in regard to coordination and determination of standards in institutions for higher education or research and scientific and technical institutions. It is obvious that neither coordination nor determination of standards is possible unless the central government has some voice in the determination of standards of teaching and examination in universities, both old and new. If we observe this statement, we can see that it is the intention of the framers of this bill to have control over the universities, at least with regard to coordination of standards of examination. If that is the object with which this motion is brought, then I wish to submit that they should have introduced a bill for controlling the universities. If we go through this bill, my suspicion that the objects are not very clear to the framers of the bill is confirmed, because on the face of it, the title of the bill is University Grants Commission Bill. So the object that is intended is that a commission should be established and the commission should have control with regard to the utilization of the funds that are given to the universities. It means that the University Grants Commission should control the universities in respect of spending the grants that are made to the universities. But if you look at the provisions of the bill, they go far beyond this. Several clauses are provided here, not only for university which receive grants, but for all universities which have been asked to furnish particulars to the commission and to observe certain other conditions. Then they will also be made liable to certain penalties in case they fail to submit returns. I could have understood if these clauses were made applicable only to universities which receive grants, but it is not so. As per definition, university means a university established or incorporated by or under a central act or a state act under the concurrent list. So, I wish to know from the honorable members what exactly is the object of this bill to have some sort of control over universities, to regulate the universities. Then I am afraid this bill will not do. He must bring forward another bill called the Universities Bill, in which they can have any provision to assume control over universities to any extent. On the other hand, if the object of this bill is only to exercise control over the spending of the grants made to the universities, if this to be made applicable only to such universities as are applicable to the Grants Commission, then I am afraid some of the provisions have to be deleted entirely or materially altered. This point I wish is to be made clear. Coming to the composition of the commission, it has already been observed by some of the honorable members that the number is either small or large. One lady member said that the number is small, while another honorable gentleman said that the number is large. The University Grants Commission provides for a small number, that is 5. And it should be so in order to make this commission effective. Sir, I wish to submit that the number should not be large. We all know by our experience in the working of committees and commissions that a large commission or committee means only procrastination or delay in working. If the commission is large, the quorum will also be large and members may not come, and therefore meetings will have to be postponed and delayed. In the interest of success of this University Grants Commission, it should be an efficient body. It must be a small body. I think 5 would do, and I wish to direct the attention of the committee to this aspect. The members of this body should be very eminent educationalists. With regard to composition, a provision is made for appointment of members from among the vice chancellors of universities. That is provided in sub clause A of clause 5. Sir, this is a matter which involves a very great principle. When universities are applicants for grants, which it be advisable to put the vice chancellors of those universities on the commission. We want this University Grants Commission to be an impartial body. We want the members of this commission to be above all influences. Even the Honorable Parliamentary Secretary, who moved this motion, has admitted that the University Grants Commission should be above politics and above all favoritism. If we have to do it, there should be no subjective element in the composition of the commission.